Hello and welcome to today's Daily Market Update with me, Joshua Mahoney, research analyst here at Alpari UK. A pretty dire start to the morning's trading today. We've had these OECD economic growth forecasts that have come out. Now, the only strong point to really come out of this was Japan, and they're saying that they're going to have better than expected growth. That obviously is going to be in line with some of the different monetary policies that they've got coming out of the region. However, when you look to some of the other areas, such as the US and the Eurozone, it's a much more of a bleak picture that we're looking at. So with the US, they've sort of downgraded them, much like they have within the Eurozone, but they've also mentioned the whole tapering of QE over in that region, and they suggest it should be occurring within the foreseeable future. So then that also plays into what we've been hearing out of Ben Bernanke and some of the other Fed members, and really ratifying what they've been discussing. Lastly, we're looking at that Eurozone, and basically every country within the Eurozone was pretty much downgraded in terms of their growth forecasts. Eurozone as a whole was downgraded to expect minus 0.6 growth over the year. And really, it was these comments that came out that they basically said they thought that US-style quantitative easing measures were the way forward for the Eurozone, and that's what they should be looking at going forward. Now, this is really what I discussed yesterday in terms of if the Eurozone does start implementing quantitative easing policies in the same way that the US does, then this could really be the catalyst that's going to bring this equities rally higher, even if we do see this tapering off of QE in the US. Now also, we had a growth forecast for the Chinese region coming out of the IMF. And again, this was a downgrade, so this came down from 8% to 7.75%. Obviously, we've got massive implications for the global economy with the Chinese economy, because obviously we have the likes of the Eurozone, the US, and obviously places like Australia and New Zealand that really do feed into the Chinese economy massively. So that downgrade also helped push the markets lower. Elsewhere, later today, we have this European Commission country-specific policy review basically coming out. And what we're looking for there is that they're likely to bring a sort of negative tone to the UK economy and give some suggestions for what the UK should be doing. I'm looking for them to potentially move away from an emphasis on austerity and more towards growth, as I mentioned yesterday. And also, with regards to some of the other countries that they can actually implement sanctions and fines upon, I'm looking towards Spain and France in particular. Now, last year when they released this same report, they didn't actually have the opportunity to do anything about it. They didn't have any powers, so it was more of a slap on the wrist and more of a naming and shaming policy. And however, now they actually have the powers to be fining people, to create sanctions. I don't expect it to actually be happening, but I do expect them to be putting some pretty harder line narrative down, in particular on the likes of France and Spain, and what they need to be getting themselves out of the current downturn. Now also, I want to see a move away from some of that austerity tone and more towards growth, so I'm looking for that later on in the day. Also later, we have that Canadian rate decision. Now, it's been at 1% for a really long period of time now. We've got Mark Carney on his way out in July the 1st, so don't expect this to show any sort of change. However, people are now questioning whether the Canadian region is going to be the next area to see some form of downturn. So some of the comments that will come out alongside that will be interesting to see. Tomorrow we've got the US GDP figure. It is a revision, it's the second revision. Previously we had it at 2.5%, and so I don't expect it to change too much from there. But then again, that's another major thing for the markets to be looking forward to. So that's it for today, guys. And if you want any more news and analysis, come and check out the Alpari newsroom at alpari.co.uk/newsroom. Or come and check me out on Twitter. My name's Joshua Mahoney, research analyst here at Alpari UK. Have a great day.